Acting CEO Nico Bezuidenhout says the state-owned airline is in big trouble and urgent steps must be taken to keep it as a going concern. Bezuidenhout is currently addressing the media at the airline's headquarters in Johannesburg. Now, our reporter Mogeni Mutwa is at that briefing. He joins us on the line. Some more trouble for South African Airways. Mogeni, what can you tell us?
Well, basically, Nico Bezuidenhout says that, SAA, as most of you are aware, that it's been relying on government to keep it afloat for many years now. But he says that actually the last time SAA got a cash injection from government was in 2007. Since then, it's been getting guarantees from National Treasury. Guarantees is just a promise by the government that if SAA borrows money and it fails to default, government will then pay for it. But now the airline apparently is cash-strapped. It's approached government for more guarantees, and National Treasury has basically turned them down and insisted that it meets certain conditions before it can give them more guarantees. He says SAA at the moment is surviving solely on debt financing. So he has come up with a plan. He calls it a 90-day plan of steps that must be taken to basically turn the ship around. Of course, he complained bitterly about the fact that the upheavals at the board level are making life very difficult for SAA. The SAA has not had an AGM in 3 years. It has not released financial statements in 3 years. And he has identified three urgent steps that need to be taken. First is to reevaluate some of the routes that SAA is flying once more. He says, for instance, they are losing about 800 million rand on the routes to China, and the routes to Southeast Asia, India, Hong Kong are also not profitable at all, and they are losing money there. So there's some reconfiguration of the routes that needs to happen. But also, he says that he thinks the company needs to be restructured, the assets of SAA, because SAA is not just flying planes, but it's got the SAA Technical, which is a business on its own. It's got a catering company, which is the biggest in Africa. And he says it's urgent that SAA attracts investors or equity partners who can invest in some of these businesses. But for that to happen, they need to be structured properly, not to be part of the group as it is at the moment, because that's going to make it difficult to attract equity investors into certain parts of the company, Devin.
Well, and I suppose that basically sums up the plan that Bezuidenhout had. It was anticipated that he will announce some more details on the rescue of this airline. Does that sum it up?
It does. But also, what also needs to be noted is that this plan has not been approved by the SAA. I think it's got a new board. Some of the previous board was many members were fired. Only three were left. Apparently, new members have just been appointed. They're going to need time to settle in and be briefed about what's going on. Time that SAA doesn't have. But he's been very happy about the cooperation that he's been receiving from the Minister of Public Enterprises, Lynn Brown. So he says part of implementing this or getting this implemented is that there needs to be a way to make sure that SAA gets things approved quicker than before, even if the board continues to be dysfunctional and maybe they don't hold as many meetings as they should, but there must be a way that SAA management is able to get approvals for whatever they need to do. Of course, it's a very fast-changing environment, as quick as possible, Devin.
All right, thanks very much indeed. Mogeni Mutwa there at the South African Airways press conference. More details in our later bulletin.